champion. Remember when they never like stucco? Now swap, baby, can't say hello. Cupid hit with an arrow. Feds on my hand, I'm peril. That ain't my ex, that's a TBT. Remember when I used to rep GBG? We lick pussies down like DBE. My girl says she want BBC. She probably gonna end up on BBC. Come famous, fuck how they feel. I'm the new king of drill. King of the jungle, no mumble, Royal Rumble, king of safari. Miss Somali want me, she told me she think I'm Marley.
Alright, so we basically got like under 10 minutes to shop, do all our shopping. There isn't much that I'm gonna buy, but this is just the stuff I buy for bulking, innit? But yeah, we're gonna start off with some bananas. I usually just chuck these in my smoothies, but my protein shakes, but they're good just to have as a snack on, just a snack on. So yeah, gonna get some bananas. So we got some bananas. That's the first thing we're gonna buy. Now I'm gonna look for some chicken chunks. I do know how to cook drumsticks, innit? But chicken chunks are easy. Like I think they're called diced chicken breast. That's what I usually have. And it's easy to make like a chicken stew with them. So yeah, this is it right here. I don't know if you can see it. Diced chicken breast. And I'll just get one of these for today. Now we're gonna look for some rice. Usually for the rice, I get these microwavable packs. I can just chuck in a microwave. I know how to make rice, but I can't be arsed. Most of the time I don't have time to cook, so I just use those and they're easy to use. Here they are. I just get the Uncle Ben's ones. And I'll get the smoky barbecue. And I get the spicy fry. Yeah, they're literally doing the announcements now, so I've got like a few minutes to get out of here. So yeah, we got the spicy Mexican, and then the other one's barbecue. I'm looking for the vegetable, there it is. I'm gonna get two of the spicy Mexican. But I just realized I was talking bare without the camera even rolling. But yeah, next I'm gonna look for this tomato paste. It's I don't know if you've seen what Joe Fazer does, but he just gets the tomato paste and just chucks it on the pasta and it gives it a little bit of flavor. It's really good for bulking. I can make a whole tomato sauce, but if I'm lazy, just to check the tomato pesto or whatever on the pasta and it tastes good. I'm waffling bears, but yeah. I also usually have buy tuna chunks, but I got a ton at home, so I don't need to buy them. All right, so this is the Tassandri tomato paste. This is what you chuck on the pasta. It's like some pesto or whatever. Tastes really nice. But yeah, we're gonna grab a bunch of that. I'm gonna grab like 3 bottles till I run out. The green one's nice, but it's not the best. I think it's best just to stick with the tomato flavored one. Now all I need is some yogurt. Yogurt for dessert, man. These right here, bro. My favorite thing to eat. I'll just get a bunch of these. I'll take all of them, in fact. And that's it, we should be good. That's all our shopping for today. Tomorrow I'm gonna buy some more stuff. I'm only just buying these because we're in a rush. Shop's about to close, but this is all you really need to bulk. Simple as that. You just need your protein, which you get from your chicken, and your tuna chunks, and that's really it. Some carbs from your pasta. Yeah, it doesn't really matter too much. Yeah, and that comes to £24, basically 25. All right, man. That's all our shopping done. We're just gonna go home. I don't know if the chicken will last. I don't wanna take too long in the gym. Thank you. I just realised the one thing I didn't buy was ice cream. Ice cream's really good for bulking. I always put it in my milkshakes, but I forgot to buy some. I just get some regular vanilla ice cream. But it's calm, I'll buy it tomorrow. Incline and flat, and we did flies. That's what we've got to do, man. I feel like you don't really need to do too much to gain muscle. I feel like if you're going through 4 to 5 workouts, maybe 4 you can do, but if you're doing 5 workouts, bro, I feel like that just shows that you're not training hard enough. Like, on them flies, I was struggling to go through them flies. Like, obviously I could have pushed myself, I was being a bit lazy, but at least I went. I need to kind of build back that consistency, because lately I actually haven't been going gym as much. I'm still roughly the same strength anyway, but I definitely haven't been going gym as consistently as I used to. So I need to build that discipline to just go on the days I don't even feel like going. Because even if I go and it's shit, it's a shit session, I don't really push myself as hard as I could have. I'm still contributing to gaining muscle. If you're just gonna go on it when you feel like it, you're never gonna gain muscle. You're gonna have to go even on the days you don't feel like it. So that's all I did through 2021. 2021, I was so focused. There were sessions where they were kind of shit, but at least I went, and that's why I feel like I was able to build the physique that I have now. Obviously, it's not a crazy physique, but it's pretty good. So yeah, consistency is the most important thing. Obviously, train hard as much as possible. You want to try to train hard every session, but as long as you're going, that's the most important thing. If you can't even stay consistent, you'll never gain muscle. Not even just gain muscle in life, you'll never achieve anything in life. You can't even be consistent, bro. That's just the basic stuff, bro. Like, that's just minimum, bro. That's getting yourself in the door. Even on TikTok, I wouldn't have even got to 10K if I wasn't consistent. The reason why my views plummeted a bit is because of I wasn't consistent. And I blame no one but myself for that. That's the mentality you gotta have. Look at yourself, blame yourself. No, I was being lazy. I was making excuses. But if I really want to go somewhere with this TikTok stuff, not even just TikTok, but social media, and ever build a business for the in the future around fitness, I'm going to have to cut out the excuses, because success doesn't care about your excuses. All right, I'm finally home. Just struck 12. Finally back from the gym, man. So this is everything I'm going to unpack. It came to 24, 44. This is everything, man. We got some bananas, some more bananas. Uncle Ben's rice. You can just chuck this in the microwave and eat it. Cause the thing that makes bulking hard is, you have to grow your stomach, like you have to force the food in so your stomach becomes larger. So I haven't even really been eating that much food. I haven't really been getting my calories in. So that's what makes bulking harder. Once you make your stomach bigger, once you've done all the stuffing, you're just going to be hungry all the time and it's easy to get your calories in. But the first few weeks, it's kind of hard, bro. And yeah, we got some other more Uncle Ben. Some more of the vegetable rice. And then we got the smoky barbecue. I do think the spicy Mexican is the best flavor. Then we got some quick cook pasta. Some more pasta. And then we got the sun-dried tomato paste. This is the stuff that we're gonna put on our pasta. And we can't be asked to make a whole tomato pasta sauce. So yeah, and it tastes really good, man. Trust me. Some more. And like I said, I did forget to get our ice cream. That's the thing I always usually put in my protein shakes ice cream, but it's cool. I'll just grab some tomorrow. But yeah. Ice cream is really good to put in your protein shake because it helps you bump up the calories. So yeah. And then we got a bunch of these. These are like 10 grams of protein each. So there isn't really that much. I wouldn't really say it's worth getting them because they are quite expensive. I think they're a pound each. But I just love them so much. Like they just taste so good. So I cut them. They're like 10 protein each. It says 15, but when I scanned it on MyFitnessPal, it said it was only 10.